it's me, Mary Ferriello, here on the pre-carpet, red carpet show. As you note, I am wearing the Hope Diamond, worth millions of dollars, and yes, it was given to me, as tonight I am here at the premiere of Sandtrap. Our first is one of the leading stars, known very well throughout the industry, Renee Doyle. Renee, so happy to have you here tonight.
Oh, I'm thrilled to be here.
And what is it you're wearing tonight, Renee?
I'm wearing John Jones's black outfit and Mary Schwartz's white pants.
Oh, and these earrings to die for. Unbelievable.
By John McKenzie.
Woo! So, Irene, what do you think about the premiere tonight?
Oh, I'm so excited. I'm thrilled being here.
And you walked the red carpet, we see?
Yes, I did. I walked already. Thank you.
And I hear you were, based on your stature, that you were the first one here to walk the carpet tonight.
Yes, I was.
You must be very excited
about that. Oh, I'm thrilled.
And the premiere with all your family members.
Oh, yes. Okay. Yes, I am.
Thank you, Irene. Look forward to seeing you this time. Back to you. And the evening continues here on the red carpet. We have an abundance of stars about to come, many of whom you know from Sandtrap, and other family members who are excited to be here, with jewelry and unbelievable footwear, as well as dresswear. Who do we have now? The first two? Kate and Kristen. Oh my goodness, it's the double K's. Kate and Kristen Kaplan. How are you? Look. And what are you wearing?
A skirt and a top.
And the designer is?
Abercrombie,
wow. Now, let me ask, because I know that everyone is looking forward to this premiere and we have so many people watching. Do you think other girls your age will be going out to buy these skirts because you're wearing them to the premiere?
Definitely.
Yep.
Yeah. And these, oh my God, fashion accessories. Talk about that. And peace. And we have peace sign here and we have the crown jewel. The jewels. How much is that worth, Kate?
$1,000.
Wow, and Kristen?
$150.
Wow, unbelievable. Are you too excited for the premiere?
Yes.
Ecstatic. Okay, you gonna go on in? Please note, these were the number two to walk the red carpet, these two girls. Thanks, girls, enjoy. Look forward to it. Okay, oh, I can't believe it. It is.
Check right here.
And the make of this bike, who would that be?
It's a Thomas special. Thomas Ferriello special.
And
get my good side.
And what led you to come in on this extravagant bike tonight?
Well, I knew this was a Sam Fitz premiere on the red carpet. Well,
with ashes on the red
with
carpet.
With ashes. In this smoke-free environment. That's all I can say right now. Thank you.
Thanks for coming, Steve. And who do we have next? It is the parents of Kate Kaplan. The parents of Kate Kaplan are here. Darren and Valerie Kaplan. Oh my goodness, Valerie, what are you wearing tonight? Unbelievable, stunning as always, figure beyond belief like a teenager.
Like my brother, I'm wearing a Ferriello collection. Except this is from the female Marie Therese Ferriello.
And I'm wearing the regular guy look, the Rodney Dangerfield collection. From Easy Money.
So excited to be here.
And the diamond, oh, did you get that? Look at that. Stunning, stunning. What's the value of that diamond, you believe?
Priceless.
No,
my sister-in-law bought it for me today. and my brother, thank you.
All right,
and are you excited to see your daughter tonight in her premiere?
Yes.
Oh, yes.
And we've waited a long time for this.
And
very
what about
long,
your two sons? Please note they have all three children. That's the talent in this family is beyond belief. Thank you.
Okay,
all right. I think
so many more to come.
The producer's mother is here now, Catherine Marie Doyle. Oh my goodness. And her dog, Gita Rita Pumpkin Eater. Oh my God, what are you wearing? Oh, are you ecstatic?
Scarlet Knight.
And even left the tag just for Scarlet Knight.
You can return it, that's cool.
Oh my goodness. And your pup. Your pup, how handsome. Look at him.
Ruff, ruff.
Yes. So how do you feel this evening?
I've never been this
thrilled and excited in my life.
I heard they have Prosecco just for you here.
Ooh, my son is the director, he's the producer, and he's the writer.
I heard.
Very exciting.
And also the cameraman, to my
And the cameraman, and the cameraman. But not the star. The stars are other relatives.
And yet he remains so, you know,
so humble.
Conceited.
He's a humble man.
Please go in.
Oh, thank
you,
thank you. No, my daughter's sweating.
I believe it's Vic and Eve Palumbo. They have nephews, nieces, great nephews, great nieces. Unbelievable the amount of people. There's sister and sister-in-laws in this place.
So glad to be here.
Oh, my dear.
Vincent, look! Vincent, how are you, Vincent? What are you wearing?
I'm wearing a Pierre Cardin shirt.
Cardin? And Eve, what is... Oh, that you look at Eve with all the...
Oh, look at this!
Oh,
have
my
you ever
goodness.
Seen anything so great? Look at this!
Look at this look, woman, stunning!
Look at this!
I guess it's... What is the value of all your diamonds?
Oh, it's got to be at least $2 million.
Wow. Do you have insurance, Eve? Do
no, no insurance.
No,
I don't believe in insurance.
This woman, look at the face. The honest John she is.
You know, I think there's going to be another premiere of all the interviews. You know? Thank you very much for inviting me.
Thank you. Eileen Doyle. It's Eileen Doyle is the mother of the infamous Chel Turk and... Chel Turk and your other son in this movie? Zachary Turk?
Mm-hmm.
There they are, coming in together. Zach, Chel, and Eileen. Hello, hello, Familia. So great to see you. Hello. What are you wearing today?
I'm wearing a Valiol with a WM. Wendy's mother.
Please note. The only person here tonight with the hand of God. Right here. Chel, we haven't seen you since the last film. You've been, I heard, jet setting all over Pittsburgh and elsewhere. And
they let me out of rehab to come in. That was very nice of them. You know, when I first read the script for this, I was worried that I'd be typecast because this is my fourth consecutive role with an eye patch, but when I got through towards the end, I realized it was really something powerful that I should be a part of for everyone's good, not just for mine financially, but mostly for mine financially.
Mitch, we've never seen you before, the two eyes together without the patch or any type of glasses. Mm. Are you willing to show that this evening?
That's something I'll have to say for the after party, man.
Okay, thank you. Zach, man,
it,
a few
huh?
words. Zach.
Hey, glad to be here.
So happy to have you. Thank you for coming.
Yes,
I know often
you.
In the summer you travel to Jamaica or Long Island or Orchard Beach, and yet you chose to come here. We're really happy.
Thank you for having me. Can't wait to smash that thing out.
Good. Can't wait to see you do that.
Thank you, darling. Love you.
Love you. Love you. Love you. Steve Doyle, Stephanie Chalalis. Aunt Malcolm of all of these.
I'm so embarrassed.
Stephanie, who are you wearing tonight? Always.
I am wearing the Royal Collection.
The Royal Collection.
The Doyle Collection.
The Doyle Collection. double hoop earrings. Please note that.
Not single, but double.
Double hoop earrings.
Not
in
one,
each of these.
Or two.
Very good. Two. He always did well in math, Stephen Doyle. If you didn't know before, I'm sure they'll call you from St. Clair's. They do remember.
Real class. See, the dog needed some water. That's because I was a Boy Scout. And I can't do three fingers anymore. What happened to Stalupa, the producer?
He's all about animal life.
Animal. See, look what I did for the dog. The little dog was dying for water. See? Only I worried about the animal. All of these people were worried about themselves. Me, the animal came first.
And I should have called St. Clair.
You're running out.
Tom Ferriello walking the red carpet. Let's give him a hand. Tom Ferriello. Tom, when we last saw you, you were but a mere child. Shorter than I, and here we are today, a man. With you're carrying your money around like nothing. I see money and diamonds. What's the value of all this you're wearing tonight?
over $10 million. After the movie, I got a lot of signing contracts with different milk brands.
Milk brands?
They saw my great talent and how I worked with the milk. And it just went skyrocketed from there.
Wow. And you took up smoking. Is this just something you do casually, or is this a regular basis?
No comment.
Thank you. Thank you. Luke Kaplan. This was the premiere for Luke. This is the first time he was ever featured in a film. I heard he did a phenomenal job. Luke, so glad to have you. How are you doing? Look, you've been, you know, we've seen you since the movie, always in a casual look, being so confident with yourself. You know, what is it you think that, I mean, there are teenagers all over the world trying to dress just like you. What do you think of that?
I don't know.
Oh, here comes
the caterers.
Dress casual.
Okay. Luke, congratulations. Thank you. Get the caterers. DJ Kaplan, a.k.a. Darren Kaplan, now walking the red carpet for the first time. Darren, so great to have you here. How are you? Darren, what was it like working with Glacier and with Chell Turk and Zach Turk and all these long-time famous actors? How did you feel in your first movie?
It was all right, I guess.
Any fans at home or family or friends? I know you have all your family here tonight, very talented family. Your two siblings, your parents, cousins, any shout-outs?
No.
Thank you, Darren Kaplan. Before we go to the next person, everyone, the producer, director, writer, and cameraman, Glacier, is here.
Hey, everybody. Hey, out there, TV land. How's it going? How's it going, Mary? You look fabulous.
Thank you.
And all the stars in my picture really look great tonight. I want to thank them all for being a part of it, too. We had a lot of fun. I think the audience and then the American viewing public is going to have a lot of fun for the next 3 months, however long this is in theaters. I hope, you know, a whole year we can take on Avatar at the box office. I see a billion dollars.
The prediction is well beyond Avatar, yeah. Well beyond Star Wars,
yeah, well,
the
be.
Titanic. You know, how are you feeling about this? Because you've had so many films that have done well, but this is like a breakthrough.
Well, let's go over them. You got Why Did You Kill Me? Shattered Lungs, So That's Why You Killed Me, Maui Marriott. But this one, I really branched out, and we tried to bring in the whole family. We waited till the cousins got old enough, had enough, you know, acting chops, and they really came through. And I think this is spectacular. Plus, Avatar's 3 hours. This is 18 minutes.
Wow.
You can watch this like six times, you know, before you watch one Avatar.
If you have a TV in your bathroom, and maybe you're brushing your teeth, showering, shaving.
Oh yeah.
You know, soon when it's on DVD, you can watch it every morning.
Put in your iPod, jog to it. You know, just listen to the audio. There's a lot of options with this. It's great. Chell Turk did an amazing job. He was my right hand man with writing and producing and some camera work. But acting wise, you're going to be blown away by his performance. Let me just tell you that right now. Kristen Ferriello, the other star, along with myself, another impressive debut to say the least.
Well,
you're going to see a lot of big things from this girl throughout the years. And Kate Kaplan, smaller role, but equally impressive and stunning. Stunning on the beach. You wait till you see Kate Kaplan on the beach. Men's hearts will be racing across the country.
But I have to ask, it must be difficult. I mean, aside from having, you know, a casting of so many actors, especially the age group, and the fact that they're all family, how do you keep them all in control?
Oh, if you're going to bring that up, you're going to go there. I got to say, the studio executives were a little tough on this one. I think some of the actors felt we got squeezed a little bit with our time constraints and stuff like that. We wanted to go even bigger than what you're going to see, but it still came out to be a great picture. But it was a little give and take, as it often is, between the actors and the directors and the studios. It was a little tough, but it was overall a really great experience.
And I heard of all your films, this was the lowest budget because, to my understanding, the heiress, Catherine McCaffrey, did donate her home for the film because she was so excited to have a film directed in your house. What are you doing?
Filmed entirely on location in Cutchogue, Long Island, and there were some great props there, so thank you to Catherine as well. And it was really a team effort. A lot of people pitched in, and I've been editing this movie for a couple of months. I made people wait for a year. They didn't like it. They wanted it at Christmas. I said, no, it's got to be done right. And it's done right.
Exactly. And I heard you've been at the free party in Pearl River, New York all day.
Uh-huh.
We weren't allowed to film. We did try to come in. I heard there was a pool party in Olympics.
You've done a great job as host. Great job
Thank
as
you.
For Mary Ferriello as host. And you've done a spectacular job hosting this red carpet pre-show party. So thank you very much.
The cars out here are unbelievable. I see your mom's Mercedes is
yep.
here.
Yep.
Your Uncle John is a 65 T-Bird convertible.
Yeah.
The Mitsubishi Zach has.
I came up in a Prius. I drove a Prius. I'm watching the environment, you know. My mom's driving the Benz, you know. I'm giving her the royalty checks. So.
I heard Chell and Zach's mom is driving a brand new Honda.
Wouldn't surprise me. Wouldn't surprise me. She's that kind of girl, you know. So there's nothing left, I guess, other than to just let it roll, you know.
But I gotta ask you one more thing.
One more thing, sure.
How do you get such a cast to work together so well, to come together for a pre-party, to drive all the way here for the preview, for this premiere? How do you do it? Why do they want to do it for you, Glace? Why?
They love me and I love them.
This is Mary Ferriello signing off.
Whoa!
That
Hello.
Disappointed from Police Academy!
Woo! Hello!
DJ!
Hello, Dad. I think it's supposed to be blindfolded, no?
Whoa! Come on, let that candy out! Woo! One twinkle!
One twinkle! That's all you could do, a twizzle?
Okay. Jackie!
Woo! Oh, so dangerous.
They went. We started the youngest. We got an order of
eight. Come on, let's go.
Come on, finish it off.
Finish the fight.
Anything. Okay. Is someone missing?
Got everyone there.
Hey, Sam.
All right. Hi.
Got the whole gang.
Should the lights be on?
No.
Perfect. Hello.
No, shut those too, John.
Guy.
I know,
but
why does he need a
treat? No, don't worry. Everybody, listen up. Grab yourselves a new computer. Did you see your name was?
Pam.
You heard the sound of a Colt 45 firing at your feet, and you chose to jig for your life in a Turkish prison? Of course not.
And a black mark from the glove you wore to carry out your murders. Mystery solved, and I'll go call the police.
Father was a drinker, his mother cried.
Doyle's 50th t-shirt spotted there.
Uh-oh. Well, what happened to everybody else?
I told you, I never lose a competition.
Oh, boy.
Thank you.
acoustics are superb.
Hi, it's me, Mary Ferriello, here. At the after party, oh my God. Glace, I can't believe it. The ensemble was to die for, but the storyline was humor and drama and mystery.
Like this, it went like this. Six Flags has nothing on Sandtrap in terms of roller coaster rides. But you know, I gotta give credit to the actors, you know? It was a brainstorming session when I was writing the script. A lot of people were giving me ideas and everyone chipped in with a little something. Lactose intolerant, that line was ad-libbed from Zach. And Mitch came up with a lot of his stuff. And Kate did a great job on that beach scene. I love that beach scene where I go down to Kate. That's one of the best scenes, I think, in terms of something that looked legitimate. The way she was flung out of the picture. Of course, she was concerned about the fake drowning in the water, so you saw there was a real quick cut because she was like, 1 second and out, 1 second out. Couldn't do a quick drowning.
But I heard that she didn't want anyone else doing the stunt. She didn't want to replace her. She wanted to do her own
all
stuff.
Herself. But if you notice, there's a lot of things you notice in this movie, which you won't get on the first video, but the one thing you notice, when John discovers her on the beach, she didn't want her hair to get sand shells, so she's laying like this. Her hand is under her head, so her hair is not getting all sandy or anything. So she died like this. But yeah, the cameos from John Ferriello and Renee Doyle there, saving the day at the end. Grandma Mortimer, wow.
Sam, I use your formal name right now. I've been asked, me, Mary Ferriello, who's wearing the Hope Diamond. I've been asked by the Academy, and you know the Academy Awards usually come around in January, February. Look for me then, Channel 7. But anyway, they've asked that, you know, we give the award right now to Best Director and Producer.
Whoa.
And this is...
Oh, wow.
Grace.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you. This is great. This is humbling. I don't know what this is. I mean, I've been giving you speeches. It's just a lot of fun. You know, it's hard work, so in a few years we'll come up with a script. We'll do another one, you know, just do one every 5-6 years.
How long are we
going to live? Well, you know, I don't think we want to go through this again anytime soon, but I'm glad we have this preserved family memories for a lifetime. It's good.
Would you like to bring any of your stars
up? Come on up, Chell. Come on up, Christy.
Come on up.
Kristen, there's a heroine.
Nice job!
Kristen in here. A killer, a real killer here, Daddy.
And Grandma Mortimer! Woo-hoo! What an ensemble! Look out, Sopranos! Beautiful job! Daddy, you surprised me with that stunning involvement. And DJ as the killer, that was a surprise.